been watching us, you know we put the bottom rev shelf in before we went on vacation.
Does it work?
Yeah.
All right, Don, we've got cabinet number one. We gotta get started on cabinet number three. What's your plan?
Unfortunately, I spilled some coffee on the plan.
The outlet box is going to sit in the kitchen.
Can you see the hole?
Hi!
This is what you call the shower peephole.
I'm showering! Get out!
Of course, nothing is square. Even our back wall, which goes to the bathroom, somehow there's a little bow in it, so we had to scribe the back for each of those pieces that touch the wall.
Wrong direction.
How is this so off? I thought we got this right.
We're Mela and Don.
We uprooted our lives and left Los Angeles
with the dream of converting an MCI D3 40-foot bus into a tiny home on wheels. We're sharing our progress
one bite at a time.
What?
How to eat an elephant one bite at a time. Since we're out of all of our scrap wood, first thing we're doing today is running over to the hardware store and getting some more wood.
It's been a long time, hasn't it, since we bought any wood.
Finally have some sunshine. Most of the snow is melting. Unfortunately, that means everything's getting muddy.
We've had this short little window of some really good weather. So we took advantage and brought our sawhorses outside. Watching us, you know we put the bottom rev shelf in before we went on vacation. We just had to build the support structure around it.
Is it in place?
Yeah.
One wall up for the rev shelf structure. Now we gotta measure the next one.
Give it a try.
I started the day solo. Mello was doing some editing and got a couple pieces of wood cut. Didn't make nearly as much progress as I thought it was going to. Of course, nothing is square. Even our back wall, which goes to the bathroom, somehow there's a little bow in it, so we had to scribe the back for each of those pieces that touch the wall. Master plan.
I need you to hold this.
Okay.
pockets the wrong direction. Put pocket screws on the wrong side.
How is this so off? I thought we got this right.
Yeah, there's my arrow. So this side was on this side. It goes the other way around. Yeah.
Is it the right way now?
Yes.
Pocket screws in the right place?
Yes. I'm starting to panic.
As we were putting this together, we decided that there was quite a bit of space above the shelf that was not going to be used, so we decided to put in a bonus little shelf.
And then there was also a lot of talk about where the electrical is going to be and if we needed to plan anything ahead. One of the electrical outlets will be on the top area near the microwave.
Spices in here, and we left a lot of space up to the shelf so we can fit Tola bottles like olive oil. This one I'm thinking it's such a long skinny one, maybe like tin foil. This bottom one is going to have a step stool in it, some taller cleaning brushes, that's why we wanted the height. All right, Don, we've got cabinet number one, cabinet number two. We gotta get started on cabinet number three. What's your plan?
Unfortunately, I spilled some coffee on the plan, but I know how the main support structures go in. The tricky part's gonna be, once we get those in place, how do we figure out how to make the doors or close it off? Because we need to be able to get access to our electrical back there. It's not gonna be easy, but we'll figure it out.
Always do.
Be back tomorrow, cutting up some wood, trying to figure out how to make cabinet number three.
Cabinet number three is going to be interesting. We had to take all our wiring down in order to put this shelf up.
We unhooked all the 12 volt and unhooked everything from our 12 volt fuse box.
The weather was fairly decent that we just jumped into building those shelves, but now it is below freezing again. We need to get the wiring all put together again with our new fuse box so that we can get the heat running.
What's so funny?
Oh, see it there.
Yeah, I think it's gonna be good.
This is going to be a boring, tedious task, and it's kind of hard for me to get the camera in there and show you anything anyway, so I think you're just gonna have to believe us.
So the electrical and all the Ethernet cables for the servo for our electrical system is in the cabinet now.
We got lights, we got heat.
Yeah, we're back in business. Moving on to cabinet number four, which will go in this area. Now we want it to be an over countertop cabinet. I've got a little sketch for it. The first thing we're going to do is go ahead and build our outlet boxes, because those will act as a support structure. The shelving unit for the cabinet can be screwed into.
We're putting an outlet in our bathroom, and we want the outlet to be flush with the wall in the bathroom because it's such a teeny tiny bathroom, but our walls are just a piece of plywood. So the outlet box is going to sit in the kitchen.
Can you see the hole?
Hi.
This is what you call the shower peephole.
I'm showering, get out. Cheesecake.
All right.
Back to the kitchen. having two sort of electrical boxes, basically, that run up so that the cabinet can sit on them, plus it'll give us a space for electrical outlets we can use in the kitchen. Before we put these two little electrical towers in, we have to get our backsplash in because they kind of fit around the backsplash.
Of course, there's no right angle, so we had to scribe the back of our support beams so they would fit against the back of the wall.
What? Too hard to see anything?
It's too hard to film this corner.
Yeah.
So we'll have two outlet boxes hidden in that one. You'll only see one in the kitchen.
It's this point in the build where it's just so chaotic.
And cutting all these non-right angles makes me feel like we're building a clown mobile. There's been grand feats of architecture, the Arc de Triomphe, Golden Gate Bridge, and now our bus's cantilevered shelf.
There it is.
Might have an obstructive view right now.
Okay,
now we don't actually have a master plan on how to make this a cabinet. The plan we had all along isn't gonna work because we need to have access to get to our breaker panel. Yeah, I know the breaker panel's been there a while, but it's just poor planning. First-time bus builders, things like this happen. We can talk about it and figure it out.
We realize now that while it was easiest when we were first pulling the power up to just put the electrical box on the bus wall, it would have been a lot better to actually run our wires up and across so that it would just be in this cabinet that's up against the bathroom wall, so that you could just open a door and it would be right in front of you.
The chances of redoing where the electrical at are pretty slim at this point. We may just move forward and make it work, whatever we can.
Talk yesterday. We're going to have some open shelving and some stacked baskets. I don't know if any of this makes sense to you yet. We've just kind of got the frames of all these cabinets. Figuring out the right order to do everything in is always a challenge, and we don't always get it right. Just realized before we start building any more shelving in this area, we do have to get all our electrical wire run. It is so incredibly hard to video anything that's going on, any work in this little area. There's very little I can show you because I just can't get a good angle. And it's better that Don just gets to work.
Got one line run dedicated for the bathroom outlet, and then I'll run another one that'll be our complete kitchen circuit outlet. All of the bathroom and the kitchen are gonna be those outlets with the trips on them, in case any water splashes into them.
Now it's working. Don is just putting markers on our wires now. Our fridge is gonna be here, so down there is gonna be our outlet where we plug the fridge into, and then the microwave on top. We just want to make sure that everything in these two shelves is just easy to take out so that we can get to that electrical box if we need to. I think this video is going to be a full move. Don's back.
Hoping it goes together.
Yeah, that's it.
Good.
I think we just have to address your gloves quickly.
Unfortunately, I have two left gloves right now, so I have to wear one upside down.
necessary will be for the Victron display. It'll show us everything about our electrical that's going on. We can also hook up some other sensors, like we can put sensors into our water tanks. All stuff that I have to learn about, but I know it's capable of it.
We got quite a few things more accomplished. Lots of little bits and bytes.
Somehow, our to-do list today, we got like a lot done, but we just, as we went, we realized all these things we still have to do. So now our to-do list just got a lot longer for next week.
We're gonna wrap this one up here. Thanks for hanging out with us again.
Next week, hopefully this will start looking good. It's all the frame for it is all there. Now we're just gonna make it look fancy.
Yeah, now we put some face on it. See you next time.
Operation Make the Cabinets Look Good is underway. Are you doing okay, honey? Are you okay to keep going with us?
I just want to be done with these cabinets.
Don has not been feeling so good.
I've been struggling the past couple weeks.
Don is lying down, taking a nap. By the afternoon, he's done. He's finished. He can't do anything more. I'm gonna get back to this little corner.